Bernard, at Tiro Olympic Juan Carlos Bermejo Shooting Range, where thousands have gathered to kick off the 51st World Championships in combined events. It's down to brass tacks, as this is the first event where the precious quota places for the 2016 Olympic Games will be allocated. I'm Hillary Russell, and I'm delighted to have Great Britain's rifle shooter Jonathan Hammond here with me today. Welcome, Jonathan, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
So tell us what we're going to see today during this final.
This is the first final of the World Championships here. We're going to see the air rifle final, and we're going to see one of our new knockout finals. They're going to be shooting 20 shots total. However, the eliminations will begin after the first 8 shots, so crucial for the shooters that they get off to a good start and sort of get ahead of the game. After 8 shots, the person in 8th place will be eliminated, and every 2 shots thereafter, the lowest shooter, the lowest score will be eliminated, and we get down to our final 2 shots on 19th and 20th shot with just 2 of them left standing. So it definitely creates a lot of excitement with the eliminations and probably a little bit more pressure for the shooters. And, so yeah, we'll see how it goes.
Firing point A, representing the Republic of Korea, we've got Kim Sang-do.
He doesn't have too much World Cup experience on the resume there, but his 1 World Cup this year, he did make the final, so I'm excited to see how he does.
On firing point B, representing Belarus, we have Vitaly Bubnovich.
Bubnovich is a very experienced shooter, by far the oldest on the field here, but this is his 5th World Championship, so he should know how to deal with the pressure.
On firing point C, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Tao Yifei.
Tao is a junior world champion, so be interesting to see how he can translate it over. Another very experienced Chinese shooter and has Olympic experience from OA.
On firing point D, representing the Russian Federation, we have Sergei Kruglov.
Kruglov's been on the circuit for a long time as well. He's been a medalist multiple times at World Cups and also has Olympic experience from 2008, so another strong Russian shooter.
On firing point E, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Liu Tianyu.
Another Chinese shooter, Liu, who also has success at Junior World Championships back in 2002. He has a lot of silver and bronze medals on his resume from World Cups, so see if he can translate that into a gold.
On firing point F, representing France, we have Jeremy Monnier.
Monnier is a really good young French shooter. This is his 3rd World Championships, and interestingly, he won a gold medal in the Europeans in Granada a while back. So.
On firing point G, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Yang Haoran.
Yeah, Yang is definitely one of the hottest shooters right now. He's just won the Youth Olympics, but he's won some World Cups this year and definitely been one of the best.
On firing point H, representing the Russian Federation, we have Nazar Luzhenets.
Yeah, finally, Luzhenets finished off the field, and again, he's been one of the hottest shooters this year. Won 2 out of the 4 World Cups that we've had in air rifle, so he's really been shooting well.
He really has. So we do have some great talent up there today, and it's a really huge event because there are 6 quota places that will be allocated today. So whoever finishes off in the top 6 will be going home with a quota place for their country.
Yeah, the quota places are really so important in our shooting world and what a lot of people talk about. The other interesting thing today, each country can only win 2 quota places, so automatically China will only be able to win 2 with their 3 shooters, so actually only one other person's going to go home without a quota. So, you might still be able to finish 7th and take one of those quotas today.
Well, it looks like we're going to get this going on now. And we've got Yang. Like you were saying, he seems like he's just untouchable this year. He's 18 years old. And once he gets into the final, there's just no stopping him.
Yeah, it's been incredible. I mean, he's had a lot of success. He's just really come on the scene, last year and this year. But for 18 years old, it's been incredible the success he's had. And he's really managed these finals incredibly well, and he's going to be a tough one to beat today.
He certainly will, and just so everyone knows, during the qualifications, he set a new junior world record. So he's really doing a great job. I think that he finished up more or less 2.4 tenths of a point above the others.
Yeah, he definitely dominated in the qualification round. So, this is really interesting too. Our sports changed with these new finals. Can he translate you know, that success in the qualification round into the final, and you know, they're going to start back from zero. So despite that, it really means nothing from this morning other than that he's qualified. But he has been really strong in finals this year as well.
Now we're going into the first series of three shots. And how important are these first series?
Well, these are crucial. You know, like we talked about, the first elimination is after the first eight shots. So there's going to be two series of three shots together before the single shots. So you're able in these ones to at least get a bit of your own rhythm with doing three shots and you're in the 2.5 minutes, but incredibly important to get off to a solid start. You know, just one or two bad shots can really put you in a hole that you've got to dig out of. But so far everyone's shooting pretty good, so it's going to be close.
Now for the viewers who have never really tuned into this final before, what is the score that you're trying to get? What number for a shot are you trying to get?
Well, they're all trying to shoot tens. 10.9 is going to be the best score that they're shooting it right in the center. So we talk about, you know, high, deep tens are going to be, you know, your 10.6s, 10.7s, 10.8s, 10.9s. However, sometimes in a final like this, you know, just all tens are going to help you out. You know, we can see already there's been a few nines in there and even an eight. So in a big pressure, you know, situation like this, just being consistent and shooting solid shots are going to help.
Now, do you think for Kim, you know, starting off in the eight ring, that it could just be nerves?
Oh, that's just pure nerves. I mean, these guys really could shoot tens all day long if they're in practice. So, you know, first shot of a final. You know, I think this is, he's had one final at a World Cup, but definitely one of the least experienced shooters. So I'm sure there's some nerves in there. It can be hard to come back from that, but he can still, you know, shoot some, you know, you shoot a couple 10.8s, 10.9s, and things can quickly turn around.
So we've got about 35 more seconds until the series is done.
Yeah, we can see Luganitz is getting off to a strong start. And there's been some nines in there, though. Some of them are shooting pretty tight, but there's definitely a lot of pressure. The first final with quarter places on the line is definitely a big competition.
Well, just even to get into, you know, the final during the World Championships is huge. Then, like you were saying, added pressure to win a quota place for your country. But let's take a look now. Luganitz is in first place. He's got 0.6 of a point advantage over Marnier. And the crowd loves him. We have got Yang in third place. He's 0.3 of a point behind. We've got Kim in eighth place. He is in the hot seat right now, 1.2 of a point behind. How hard is that to make up?
That's going to be tough. You know, 1.2 points with only another five shots to go before the first elimination. It's definitely doable. It's almost, he's going to need some help. You know, it's going to be hard for him to make that up on his own, but all it takes is one or two others to shoot an eight or a bad nine, and pretty quickly it can be close again. So he's just going to have to focus on shooting, you know, just some good solid shots and hope that he gets a bit of help.
All right, let's focus in again on Luganitz. Like we were talking about before, he has just been really great this year. He's been winning a lot of awards, and he's very humble about it, which is nice to see. He's a humble guy.
He's a pretty quiet, friendly guy, and haven't had a chance to talk to him a whole lot, but he's definitely a popular guy on the circuit, and like you said, very humble, and you know, likes to have a good time, and he's just super cool when he shoots, too. Mm-hmm. You know, nothing seems to faze him. Got a fairly bad nine there from Liu, so that's gonna, you know, straight away on that one shot, Kim's able to pull back a full point. So there's definitely time for him to claw it back.
Bubnovich starting off the second series with a 10.2.
Yeah, we've definitely got a, you know, this is the great thing about our sport. Bubnovich there, 39 years old. Against Yang, an 18-year-old. So I don't think there's too many sports that have that type of age range, and you know, just great to be to see that in a final in a competition of this level, to have that age range.
It's true, and also, you know, it's great because you can shoot up until you're much older. You
absolutely
know?
That's what I'm hoping. That's yeah, Jeremy didn't seem too happy with that shot.
He did not. We've got Tao coming off of a 9.9. He started off quite strong. We've got a little less than a minute left for the series.
Yeah, 2.5 minutes is pretty comfortable for these guys. They're used to shooting on a good rhythm. doesn't allow you too much time if you have to take that second or third hold, or if your heart beats up quite a lot, but it does give you a little bit of leeway. But after this, we'll go into the single shots, and then there's you don't have too much time in that for any mistakes, or sometimes you just got to be ready and go for it.
Okay, after the second series, Lu Jeanette is still holding on to first place by a half a point over Yang, who has now moved up into second place. Monye is a half a point behind him as well, and it's really tight with the rest of them. We've got Liu in seventh place, 1.3 tenths of a point behind Bubnovich, and Kim is still holding on to eighth place, only 3 tenths of a point behind Liu. Anything could happen right now to these last two shots.
He's made up some ground there and just 3 tenths with two shots to go. So, you know, most likely those two will probably battle it out. But again, the other six, you know, they can't afford a wild shot either. Otherwise, they'll be in that mix as well. But Kim's not out of it yet. He's got two shots to try and to build that up. But as you said at the top, it's incredibly close. And I'm sure they'll go back and forth for a while throughout this final. The decimals make it so much closer. And you shoot a couple 10-8s, 10-9s, and you jump right back up there, equally 1-9, and you're going to slip back a little bit.
Okay, let's take a look now at Kim. 3 tenths of a point now behind Liu.
Yeah, he'll definitely be looking for a really good solid 10 on this one.
Here the crowds are going a little bit wild there. Liu Jeanette's just at 10.7.
It's great having the crowd interaction. It's got to make it a challenge for some of the others if they're still on aim and still holding. But, you know, that's part of the sport. And I think it's definitely been made more spectator friendly and getting the crowd involved.
So we've got one more shot to go to find out who's going to finish off in eighth place. And it is Kim Sang-do, only 2 tenths of a point now behind Liu Tianyu.
Yeah, he closed it a little bit by 0.1, still got 0.2 to go, but you know that can easily be done on this shot. And if he does survive this shot, then again, you've got two more to slowly inch your way back. So this shot will be really important for Kim. And further up the leaderboard, Luganitz is now actually starting to stretch his lead a little bit with that good 10.7 on the last shot.
One more shot to go. Let's see how this goes now for Kim and Liu. Liu, who was finished off after qualifications in 17th place during the World Championships in 2010. You know, you got to take your hat off to him that he's made it into this final.
Yeah, absolutely. He, you know, had a solid year, and you know, for his first World Championships as a senior, he's making the final is a great result. So, I think Kim is going to need a 10.5 to get into a shoot-off. Oh, and look at
there
that.
There you go. He gets a 10.5.
Absolutely.
And this is what makes things very exciting here. Didn't quite see that coming. We've got Kim and Liu tied up now in seventh place, and it's going to come down to one shot to find out who is going to be going home in eighth place. It's hard to say. I don't know what to even put my money down on.
Well, this is, you know, when we get back to talking about the quarter places, France, Russia, and Belarus, I think, might all be cheering for the Chinese shooter. If Kim gets knocked out, then every other country will get a quota that's in the final. So Kim survives, he can keep working his way up, and you know, those last two shots, he closed the gap, and
nothing is impossible, that's for sure. Pressure is on Liu.
Yeah, they just got to focus and shoot the best shot that they can.
9.4
from
10.7, beautiful shot. For Kim, he has made it up into seventh place. Really, really good shooting. He is 1.2 tenths of a point behind Bubnovich. We've got two shots to go to find out. But in eighth place, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Liu Tianyu.
I think Kim would have liked that 10.7 in the actual final there to make up some more ground, but definitely shows that you can make up the ground and survive the tie shoot, and now he's got the next two in his sights to see if he can reel them in.
Lu Zhenets is shooting absolutely famously. He's 1.1 tenth of a point over Yang. What do you think about this? Do you think that he's just keep on going forward or do you think that Yang can make this up?
Well, I mean, Yang can definitely make this up for sure. I mean, even can some of the others as well. But, you know, Luganitz has been so consistent this year. If he stays on this pace, he'll be hard to catch. But, you know, there's a long way to go before the 19th and 20th shot. So I suspect Luganitz will be there, but plenty of time for the others to catch.
That's right. You never, ever know on this. When you first start watching the final, you think, okay, they've got this wrapped up. And then it's the last shot always, and all of a sudden, everything changes.
Absolutely. I mean, just one bad shot can change things really quickly. So, Luganitz right now, just be trying to stay consistent. Just shoot your tens. Don't do anything crazy. And just try and build on that lead.
And a bad Lu Zhenets, 1.3 tenths of a point in front of Yang. We have Kim still in seventh place. He's now 9 tenths of a point behind Bubnovich.
Yeah, he keeps closing that gap.
He really does. And we have seen this during the World Cup season that someone who is in eighth place just slowly creeps up and creeps up, and you think, okay, he's going to be eliminated now, and then he's not eliminated. Then you think he's going to be again, and he's
absolutely
not.
Absolutely. Some of the shooters, we maybe weren't, hugely delighted with the new finals to begin with, but no one can deny that it's exciting, and we see these changes like you're talking about, where someone looks completely out of it, and they slowly, get two more shots and build their way back up again. So, 0.9 is quite a bit to make up, but,
right.
Bubnovich really just needs to shoot a 10, and more than likely he'll be safe, but you never know. Yeah, the crowd are definitely getting into it already.
They are.
Little slow clap. It's been a theme this year at the World Cups, and I think it's been good. It gets the crowd involved, makes it exciting. I'm sure it's harder for the shooters to concentrate, but they have to just block that out.
Off with a 10.7, that's very respectable. Unfortunately, it's not going to be enough to stay in the game, and it's not going to be enough to get a quota place.
Yeah, great effort there. I mean, 10.7, can't do a whole lot more, and Bubnovich just shot a really solid 10.5 to sort of close the door. So
there he is in seventh place, representing the Republic of Korea, Kim Sang-do.
So Belarus, France, and Russia breathe a sigh of relief after that
exactly.
One. They have their quota place. Now it's all about the medals.
Okay, we've got some big stuff going on here. Lu Zhenets ahead by 1.4 tenths of a point over Tao. Krugloff and Yang, who are all tied up in second place. Bubnovich is in sixth place. Two shots to go to find out who's going to finish off in sixth place. He's down 7 tenths of a point. Do you think that you can make that up?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it looks like Bubnovich and Monnier are going to be battling this one out, but again, anyone above that, if they shoot a bad 9, they're back in it, but 0.7 is definitely catchable in two shots, so it's up to Monnier here watching him to just shoot two solid shots and sort of close that door again.
9.1 there for Lu Zhenets, you could hear.
Yeah, so I heard some groans from the crowd, so that's... That's going to bring him right back in with those other guys and see what Jeremy can do here. Not happy with that.
No, not at all. 8.9, also because Bubnovich just shot a perfect 10.9. And that's
how
you move up the
2-point swing, just like that.
Exactly. So we've got Monnier down by 1.3 tenths of a point. And with that shot from Yang, we have him now. I mean, Lu Zhenets, 9.1. We have him only by 2 tenths of a point above Krugloff.
Yeah, everyone closed up. I mean, Bubnovich, moving up into fifth, but only 1.1 off the lead. So those top five shooters all within just over a point. Luganitz has really, made it a lot more exciting. Monnier, that's tough with that 8. He's going to have to hope for a little bit of help on this one. All he can do again is shoot a solid shot and see what happens.
Yeah, you were saying before that this year they really started clapping in the finals hall, which is something very unusual and new, which is good. It's really good for everyone to get involved in it. But I think that must put a lot of pressure on the shooters, and it must really mess with their concentration a bit.
Yeah, it's definitely different. It can be a challenge. I think it's one of those changes where, you know, I think the younger shooters are going to adapt a little bit better. It's going to be more normal for them, and the older shooters may take a little bit of time. But, you know, it gets the crowd involved. It's definitely, you know, we don't want it to be, you know, really quiet and silent. We want some noise and excitement.
So here we have our sixth place representing France. We have Jeremy Monnier. He put up a good fight, unfortunately just not enough. You know, Bubnovich now is 1/10 of a point behind Tao. Yang has overtaken Lujanets, who has now moved down and tied up for second place with Kruglov. This is about as tight as a final could get right now.
Yeah, now it's going to be really close. And, you know, I was just thinking two or three shots ago how Yang was, I think he only shot a 103.3 for his first 10, and he can shoot a lot better than that. But, you know, three shots later, he's in the lead, so... Now it's Lugenitz that's going to have to kind of step it up for these remaining shots, but definitely looks like a Russia-China battle at the moment.
It certainly does.
And I think Monnier is still going to be happy with getting into the quarter place. I'm
Absolutely.
Sure he'd have liked a little bit more in the final, but if you'd offered him a quarter place at the beginning of the day, he'd have probably taken that pretty quickly.
Okay, we've got Yang Horan. It does not surprise me at all to see him moving up and overtaking Lujanets. But as you can hear, the crowd's going wild after Lujanets just shot a 10.7.
Yeah, I think Yang might have just taken a wee peek at the leaderboard there while he was in position. He may not have done, but there you go. You can see him again there, just having a little look.
Having just a little duel there. Things have changed around. We now have Tao down in fifth place. Yang is still holding on to first place by 4/10 of a point. And Bubnovich has done a banner job here.
Yeah.
He's moved up into third place. You know, there's only 10ths of a point between the shooters, but it's really, really amazingly tight.
Yeah, look at it there. He's now only 8/10 off the lead, and we were talking about him, you know, trying to survive 6th or 7th a little while ago. So just shows you how they can work their way up. I mean, really tight, you know, 0.1 between 4th and 5th and another 0.1 between 3rd and 4th. So, you know, they're all in danger a little bit here if any of them shoot a bad shot. So, you know, they've still got to keep that focus and, you know, keep hammering those 10s.
Okay, let's focus in again on Cao Yifei. Zero for a cow, and that is just not going to do it.
Yeah, I think that's going to send him home. We're still waiting for Yang.
Yang, 10.5 for Yang. And in fact, in fifth place, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Cao Yifei.
That's still a great effort for his first World Championships as a senior. I'm sure China were hoping for more than one medal with three of them in the final, but they're going to have to just settle for one, possibly.
So we've got Yang, the half a point in the lead over Lujanets, and Bubnovich and Kruglov tied up for third place. And this is a tough one. These two shots are tough because it determines who's going to be on the podium and who's going to be going home in fourth place.
Absolutely, yeah. You know, you want to, you know, the difference between third and fourth and not getting a medal is really tough. So, you know, they've all got a quarter place. They'll all be happy with that, but they'll definitely want to come away with a medal. So, you know, they'll be hopefully not thinking about it too much. They should just be focused on shooting one good shot and then moving on to the next one. But I don't doubt that it enters their mind a little bit.
And they have heard what their scores are. The announcer, who's on the floor, he's giving out the scores after every shot. They also can take a look at the leaderboard anyways. And so it adds a little bit of pressure when you think, dear Lord,
yeah,
you know.
It's hard to shut that off. You can try and not look at the scoreboard, but as we watch a lot of them, they're having a peek up at the scoreboard as soon as they shoot. So they're aware of where they are. So far, Bubnovic with a 9.9, but the others are not really gaining any ground on him, so other than Yang.
Other than Yang, of course, finishing off strong as always with a 10.7. Okay, it is now Bubnovic in the hot seat. He's only 1/10 of a point behind Kruglov. This is really going to be the determining shot to find out, you know, who's got it in them to end up on the podium. They both, of course, have it in them to end up on the podium, but that's a lot of pressure. Only 1/10 of a point separating.
Absolutely. You know, and Yang's got a little bit of a lead there now, stretching out over for Luganitz and Kruglov, but, you know, the other three of them, you know, what is it, 5/10 between them, so... Bubnovic has done a pretty stellar job of moving up the leaderboard today, so needs one more really good shot to try and get that medal.
Back on now to Kruglov. The deciding fact for who's going to be ending up on the podium, who unfortunately will not be today.
Crowd definitely getting into
they
it
really
here.
They are, yes. The whole Russian team, I believe, here.
Yeah.
Luzhenets, a 10.7, waiting on Kruglov. Finishing off with a 9.2.
There we go, Bubnovic with a 10.1. That's definitely enough to make up that 0.1 difference. Still waiting on.
Now Yang, of course, a 10.6 for Yang. So finishing off in fourth place, representing the Russian Federation, we have Sergei Kruglov.
Yeah, great effort today. Shot a pretty solid final. He'll be disappointed with that last shot, but you know, a good solid match today, and fourth place, a quarter place. He'll be satisfied, but I'm sure he'll be a little ticked off for a wee while of just missing that medal.
Now tell me something, Jonathan. We've got 1 point separating Luzhenets from Yang, and we've got 1.1 of a point separating Bubnovic from Luzhenets. Is it possible, do you think, for the scoreboard to change around?
Oh, it's definitely possible. You know, it's sort of in the hands of Yang and Luganitz. If Yang keeps shooting 10-5s, 10-6s, then he's going to be pretty hard to catch. But you know what? Yeah, it's close now. It gets down to the last few shots. That one bad shot, and it can, you know, quickly switch. I mean, we saw a 2-point change earlier on with a 10.9 and an 8.9. So we can definitely have a change. We're watching Luganitz here, looks pretty steady. You can see the barrel there, it's really not moving a whole lot. I know it'd be moving a lot more if I was shooting a rifle, that's for sure.
10.1, let's go on to Yang now. Yang, you know, he just won the Youth Olympic Games, and he's just having an amazing season, and somebody we have to keep our eye on always.
Yeah, for an 18-year-old, the success he's had this year and last year has been incredible. So yeah, we'll just see how long he can be around the circuit, and there's been so many amazing Chinese shooters over the last 10, 15 years, and I'm sure he'll be trying to emulate those and do as well as he can. So he's three shots away from being the world champion if he can keep shooting those good shots.
Okay, 9/10 of a point, we've got Bubnovic down from Luzhenets. Yang is still making his great escape, 1.3 of a point behind. He seems to bask in the fact that, in the last shots, it seems Yang seems to bask in the fact that the pressure doesn't get to him, let's say.
Either that or he's so young, he's got no idea what's going on.
Could be, very well.
But no, he seems, you know, really cool. He definitely, nothing seems to faze him. And, you know, sometimes the inexperience allows you to do that. But he's also, you know, I'm sure he's had some great training, and it's very, very calm.
10.1 for Bubnovic. Luzhenets with a great 10.8.
Yeah, we'll see what Yang can do here. Luganitz may close that gap. He may not. See how Yang can respond.
10.3 for Yang. So we have got our bronze medalist now, representing Belarus, Vitaly Bubnovic.
Well, a great effort from him today to fight his way back from... I think he was sitting in 6th and 7th and pretty close to the line at the beginning, but really fought his way back and come away with a bronze medal. I mean, he's won a ton of medals over his career, but I'm sure this one will be pretty sweet.
So 8/10 of a point. Yang has lost a little bit of his lead. Luzhenets is definitely putting the pressure on him. These two young shooters, whereas, you know, Luzhenets 25, Yang 18. Very young.
Yeah, very young. Well, we talked at the beginning that these two are probably the two hottest shooters in air rifle right now for this season. I think they between them, they've won 3 out of the 4 World Cups. So, you know, very fitting that, these two have ended up the last two. And 0.8 is not that much. I mean, it can be, see who can respond the best and deal with the pressure for these final two shots.
That's 9.7. That's not going to help out.
Yep, Yang can make the last shot a lot more comfortable with a really good 10 on this one.
And he definitely has that in his sights. There's no doubt about it. He seems to handle very well to the pressure. 10.3. 1.4 tenths of a point separating Yang from Lu Zhenetsu. One more shot to go for the gold.
Yeah, it's definitely not over, but 1.4 is much more comfortable than 0.8 of a lead. So
yes, it certainly is.
He, you know, essentially he needs a 9.6 and he's safe, and I'm sure he'll know that and be having a wee peek at the leaderboard. And I would probably expect Yang to still shoot a 10, but this is our sport, this is shooting, and you never know what's going
to
happen.
Really don't. It really goes right down to the last shot. You know, everybody right now, we all think that Yang's going to be on the highest step of the podium, but you never know, you know?
Absolutely. Both being pretty patient here. There's definitely a bit of movement on his rifle there, but he still shoots the 10.
3 again, unbelievable. Unbelievable shooting. There is our silver medalist, Nazar Lu Zhenetsu. He put up a great fight. The audience loved him. He had tons of support here. And our gold medalist today, Yang Horan, no surprise at all to see him on the highest step of the podium. He's just done a banner job, and we'll have to see how it goes for him in 2015, but really somebody that we're going to have to keep an eye on. So here they are, our medalist of the day. Once again, our silver medalist, Nazar Lu Zhenetsu.
Yeah, that was an impressive final. 207.9 is really, really solid. Lubinitz there looks a little bit disappointed, but, you know, silver medal at the World Championships. He's had an incredible year as well, and both of these two we'll see lots more of them next year and probably moving on towards Rio as well. And they've both got those quarter places in the bag, and they'll be ready for next year.
So there they are, Yang, Lu Zhenetsu and Bubnovic, our medalists for today's event. Jonathan, I want to thank you so much for joining me today. I wish you the best of luck in
thank
the future,
much.
And it was really nice to have you here with us today.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much for your support.